Welcome to this week's GV Bounce. I'm Marc McGowan.
I'm Hannah Driscoll.
We're going to take you through the second weekend of round 16. It's probably not quite as interesting a round as last week, but we do have the blockbuster between Rochester and Tapper. We'll get to that in a moment. First up, Marupna and Shepparton. Now, Tim Little has announced he wants at least one win to finish up the year.
Yeah.
Can he do it?
Well, they've said they've had this goal for a little while. Obviously, it hasn't come about yet, but they've got three pretty tough opponents to try and to get that goal. You think they've got Marupna, obviously, this week, and they've got Shepparton Swans and Shep United to finish off the year. So they would have to pull something massive out to try and get that.
And but the Cats need to keep winning, don't they?
They
can't afford to drop
this
on.
No, they certainly can't. They've also got those same opponents to finish off, and they're still outside the six. Yeah. So, and you sort of think, with some of the other teams who they've got on the run home, all they can do is just keep winning.
It's a thrilling race, though, isn't it?
How great is it?
I mean, you've got three sides on the same amount of wins coming down. Always somehow works out this way, doesn't it? The draw always throws up a few interesting ones. It's obviously basically a random draw at the start of the year, but it's just uncanny. Every time, it always comes down to the last few, and there always seems to be an interesting game at the end.
Yeah.
Obviously, a few of them have played each other, and we know next round, Marupna and the Swans face off in a huge game, but we'll focus on this round for the moment.
Yes.
Ins and outs, are there any interesting ones that you missed this
week?
Well,
Tim Little himself is coming back in. He missed the Bears' last game with a calf injury.
Yep.
He's had that a couple of times this year. And then we look at Marupna. They've got a couple of guys going out with injury and so forth. Paris Sullivan was one of concern. They were worried that he might have required a full knee reconstruction, but semi-good news, I guess, coming out that it's not going to require full knee reconstruction, but Coach Blake Campbell was still unsure as to exactly how long he'd be ruled out for.
Yeah.
And Carl Lode, another omission on
the list. And he's a key out. He's been great in the midfield for the Cats.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. So, they'll miss him, but still tipping the Cats to win tomorrow.
Yeah, and the second game of the round, Euroa and Seymour. Now, these two clubs have a fantastic rivalry. In recent years, even though Seymour has had a lot more success than Euroa, this game has always been a 50-50 game. I mean, Euroa has probably stunned them a few times the last couple of years.
They have. Well, you think this year, well, Anzac Day this year, blockbuster game.
Ambrose Swindon.
Six
goals and kicked that late goal to put him in front. I was at that game. That was fantastic. It was such an enjoyable game. One of the highlights of the season, I thought.
And you think, and also, they beat them last year early in the season, and it was a draw the year before that.
It's unbelievable.
It is. It's something about these two teams.
Yep.
So.
And it's at Memorial Oval this week, and Mansfield starting to breathe down the Magpies' neck as far as that ladder position in ninth. So I know Dave Gleeson's come out in the paper today and said, not concerned with finishing ninth. We wanted to play finals. Mm-hmm. It's irrelevant. We just want to get more wins. But you'd still like to finish high, wouldn't you, Hannah?
Oh, absolutely. I think, no, I can see where he's coming from in terms of wins.
Yeah.
Like, you've got to measure it on successes. But, look, they've had a great year so far. But you also got to think teams like Shepparton Swans, Marupna, they'll be backing your roller this week, I would think.
Yeah. And before we move on from this game, the two Colbert boys, Paul and Brent, are back, and Shane Shotton, the big ruckman, back from overseas. So, look, there's still some doubt over the Colberts, so don't be surprised if one of them or both potentially don't play this weekend. But they've both been named, so every chance they're coming in.
Yep.
They're three massive ends.
Huge
ends. You'd have to back the Seymour to win. It's similar to Marupna, just can't afford to lose.
Yep. And also, it's come out during the week about Shane Robson. He's not going to be coaching at the Lions Den next year. So the Lions have already started the process of looking for a new
coach.
Want a playing coach, yeah. It seems to be coming a bit of a trend at a couple of clubs when they're looking for a new coach next
year. Luke Morgan's paved the way
this
year, hasn't he? He's shown it's possible.
Yeah, absolutely. So it'll be interesting to see where that develops. So,
And final game of the round, Rochester and Tatura. Now, there's been a lot of excitement in the office this week just from our perspective about this game. It's a blockbuster game, but imagine the clubs as well. They'd be approaching this game. It's not just another game. It's a huge one.
No, it is a huge game. Tatura are absolutely thrashing the Tigers early on in the season. Though you were at that game.
Yeah, some of the stats in the midfield were so lopsided. I mean, we're looking at sort of stats. They were doubling them in the clearances, in inside 50s. They had 16 more scoring shots. They only won by 31 points, but it was a smasher.
Yep.
There's no two ways about it. It was a lopsided game. 31 points really flattered the Tigers, but there's something different about them this time. I mean, they've won four in a row. It has been soft opposition other than the Shep Swans, but they're just starting to get going. You can just see a few of the pieces are starting to come together.
Mm-hmm.
Ash Watson will be back this week. Daniel Anderson returned a few weeks back. They're starting to get that midfield together. They've got Luke Gester and Grant Weeks both firing up forward. I mean, it's going to be a really interesting game.
But
Rochester could still get to third.
But do you think they have, like, as I said before, you saw this game. Do they have what it takes to turn around what was a pretty bad performance the first time around?
Look, it's anyone's guess. I mean, you're always guessing, aren't you? I mean, if you had a crystal ball, anyone could be a champion tipster. But look, you'd have to suggest it's going to be a bit closer. But TAT is a phenomenal side. We all know they won the premiership last year. They've got basically that same nucleus this year, so their midfield is enormous. Brendan Hollow's come in from last year. He's been their star, played for Big Country. You've got Link Wellington, these sort of guys in there. I mean, it's going to be a crackerjack game. But look, I'm leaning towards Tat, only just. Most of us have gone for Rochi, but I don't think you can jump off the Bulldogs. They're a very, very good side. So
What do you reckon of Scott Griggs' comments in today's paper about the forward line? You know, as you said before, Rochi sort of have weeks and guess you're up forward.
Yep.
Tatura sharing around the load this year. Their highest goal kicker's got 32, I think, to date. And he said he's not too worried about
that. No, he's not. He's not concerned at all. He actually made the comment it's unhealthy to have a go-to option, which I thought was a little bit interesting. But, look, you can't doubt the success they've had. He said it himself. We've scored the second most points in the competition. It hasn't been a problem for us. I think it could potentially be a problem, but what would I know? I'm certainly not a coach. I'm just someone who comments on the game. So, look, it's interesting. I'd sort of rather have Rochester's forward line. But, again, you can't argue with the Tatura's success. So. Okay. Who knows what will happen this weekend? They might prove us wrong, and one of the guys might come up and kick five or six. Who knows? But that brings us to an end this week. It's going to be a great round of footy. It always is in the GV, but particularly this one as it starts getting to the end of the year. So we hope you get out and have a look.